You know, politics and it's everyone has opinions in politics. Everyone goes a certain way. We, Stanley Weiser, the screenwriter, and myself really went about this as dramatists. That's our job. We all have opinions, but we put those aside and we go with the record because the record's incredible. It's a great story. We don't have to embellish it. The man lived an extraordinary life. He took it. I mean, you could say it's a three-act play where it took twists that nobody ever has done before, where you could say the first act was a prodigal son, a reckless, dangerous youth, in rebellion against his father, his name. Second act, he comes back to respectability. The prodigal son returns home, but not really. In the third act, you see this other version of prodigal son becomes Icarus, which, if you're a Greek myth, not Bible anymore, where he becomes the ambitious one who tries to outdo his father by flying higher with the manufactured wings, but his wings built by his father, and the wings melt in the sun, you know, and he crashes into the sea, which is what he did. He overreached. He was underqualified, I think, for the job. But that's my opinion. I think we just show you what he does. I think by most accounts, his presidency is a disaster, and history will treat him very tough, very harshly. I think I'm drawn by people who are misunderstood or, you know, I think, for example, the Kennedy assassination is really a movie made out of, because I was upset at what I think is a major misunderstanding of how he was killed and why. And I think his legacy is a wonderful legacy, actually, but it's much disputed. Nixon, interesting story because of his complexities. Bush is not a complex man. On the contrary, he's more of a John Wayne figure in the sense that he's a cowboy. He doesn't back down. He makes no mistakes. Doesn't apologize. Doesn't think about things. That's a fascinating figure for drama. It's like Oedipus. He's blind but even Oedipus in the third act wakes up. And, oh my gosh, what have I done? Right? Tears out his eyes. There's no semblance of that in Mr. Bush. So it makes it fascinating to me. It makes the joke on us. Now, we're the audience. We're watching. And it's somewhat, you're compassionate with the guy because you understand the way he thinks and feels. It is like Oedipus, but he comes to this place where there's nothing wrong. What's wrong? I did it right. And we know that that's not true. We know something is wrong in America, definitely. So it's a compassion not for Bush only, which is in the movie, but it's a compassion for our country.